our talk drunk words, so with that, don't get me all fucked up, twisted, and confused, because I'll put you out there. And you know what got me all fucked up, twisted, and confused? It's fucking Corona. It's canceling everything but the fucking bills, okay? I'm fucking tired. Mama's tired. I just found that I won't be working at the bar until April 17th. That's some shit, okay? And worst of all, my show is canceled, okay? The comedy show that I had with Mercy and Silent Storm is postponed until further notice because the corona got us all fucked up, all right? Everybody's in fear for their lives, which I think is bullshit, okay? The whole clubs, the bars, everything's being closed. I think it's bullshit, but it's whatever. It's not here and there. It's the government trying to put us all in one, have us locked down. It's a whole fucking lot of bullshit, sweetheart. But oh, when they fucking canceled the St. Panties Parade, I'm fucking done. I can't, I just can't. Then niggas wanna quarantine and chill. No, I don't wanna quarantine and chill, okay? I got fucking my friend Jenny here. There's a little background noise in the back. Well, welcome to another week of Emma's Bar Talk. Actually, look, I gotta promote On the Edge Nutrition. This is the chinola. Anybody that knows me knows that I love passion fruit. Passion fruit is my favorite thing ever. I actually put a little twist to this. I added a little priv. If it ain't priv, I don't want it. Promo. I need to be endorsed by Hennessy. I'm just saying. I give so much freaking business to them. It's not even $15 drink. Come on now. You can't beat that. So this week we got two, I want to say like pioneers of the reggaeton, the Spanish reggaeton, reggaeton. Spanish is reggaeton. What the fuck? I'm all fucked up today. See? And I already had only two double shots on this drink. I just added another one. I'm just saying. Priv. Only Priv. It ain't Priv, I don't want it. So we got Rafi and Joshua here. They're gonna be coming short soon. We're gonna do a little interview, chop it up with them. They were on a break. Not the Rachel and Ross Kyle and friends, but they were on a little break and they're back together better than ever. So, you know, let's just start the show.
First things first.
Wait, that's $10 a pop. I'll send you the bill.
Aquila,
Purell, baby. Purell that shit.
The discounter from the interview.
So we got Rafi and Joshua up in the building. You know, it's funny because Chelsea people right here. This is Chelsea right here. Yep. You know what I mean? Yep. When the reggaeton was came out, like when it was popping back in like the 2000, y'all were in it too.
We were working.
You were working. You were buzzing because your names were out there. Even when I was in Springfield, you guys' names were out there.
Yeah, that's when we were going after the dream really hard.
Yeah. So tell us a little bit how you guys started as even in the music or as a group.
Well, there was a lot of groups out there already working. Like, you know, I don't want to mention too many names, but there was groups out there working. And, you know, I was in church at the time, and I was kind of like in two waters, and I decided to, you know, just whatever, just wanted to do me. So Josh, él es familia, you feel me? Because my brother and my sister's dad.
No la ganga, son familia.
Even as a kid, you know, running around with diapers in the house, my family was over there.
It's like the sandbox type thing. Yeah.
So long story short, we fam. So whatever, he used to come to my house and I would record, and then my sister, he heard, you know, la música mía, y la hermana mía me dice, ¿por qué tú no grabas a Josh? Que, you know, él tiene una voz linda. Yo dije, you know, I never thought of that. So hicimos un tema con el panita mío. Grabamos un tema, lo promocionamos, y ahí es que todo el mundo dijo, yo, ustedes suenan bien juntos. Like, y'all sound real good together. And I'm like, yo, all right. So I told my sister, you know, invite him again. He came through and I was like, yo, a lot of people like the track. We buzzing, so let's work. So empezamos a grabar. Whatever, his name is Josh.
But mind you though, he was deep in the Christian music.
Yeah, so I was already doing some shit.
Yeah, you were already on that.
So I was that, you know, 10, 11, 12 year old kid that used to see him. I seen him from before he had anything, from when he was to write lyrics on a keyboard onto a big ass computer monitor. Mm-hmm. So I used to, like, what are you doing? And I was probably like 10, 11 years old. Oh, I'm writing some raps. Like, I kind of comprehended the music, but I didn't, you know, fully know. So then I'd seen him legit build that from all the way to a studio, record a studio. And then when reggaeton started getting like, Diego, wasa, wasa, when all that, I was still young, 12, 13, so I started loving that music.
Shit, I feel so old.
So when Rakim and Y came out, I used to sing those songs to Nina on the phone. My sister, Orlando, sola, on the phone. So he's like, yo, listen
to
Josh.
You were one of those, huh?
Yeah, he heard it. He's like, yo, come by. And we made a song. And we were like, wow. Us listening to it, like, oh, shit. Showing other people, they were like, wow, you know, like, let's get it.
It sound good.
So as Rakim and Y, do you guys kind of, like, compare more to them than other duos?
Not really.
But you want to, because of them, you guys had a dance.
I don't compare us to nobody. Yeah, because you guys have music. I just try to compare, like, or try to compete with that top tier.
Yeah. So that's like that type of level.
But I definitely feel like now we have worked like so many years already that I feel like we have like a stamp of us already.
Yeah.
We have a signature name when we do our music. Exactly. Our, so it's like it's now it's converting to a legit like a brand, us.
A brand,
you know
yeah.
what I mean? Mm. So I don't know, that's how I feel, but.
I know you guys did take a break, and I was like, you know, starting families and all that stuff. You guys are back together. Do you guys think if you guys would have not taken that break and you guys would have stuck still together,
like still going,
would you have gotten bigger than what you guys...
Hopefully.
I think that we could have. This is the problem.
Working
bro.
Consistently.
But it's like the thing, it's like family always, as
family
when you have kids
first.
And have things, it's
different. Let's defeat it a little bit, because I'm going to be honest, you know, when you're working so hard, and you know, let's say prior to him having his family and me having my kids and stuff, or me starting my family, it was tough for us. So at the end of the day, we were young, we didn't have kids.
Too.
It's discouraging where we're working so hard, and then sometimes
trying to have something happen, and it's like you bump into this, and then that
and then
bump, and
it doesn't
that,
happen.
And it's like,
so a veces uno dice, tú sabes qué, ya lo, yo no quiero hacer música.
Yeah,
eso me pasó a mí.
Yeah, those things come. Those
it
things
happens.
Come.
It happens to everybody. Everybody, any artist in the game, period, that has ever felt discouraged, that said, oh no, I never gave up. Nigga, listen.
Yeah,
there must have been a moment in time in your career or in your lifetime that you might have felt discouraged that you not even gave up, that you stopped and you thought about giving up. And then you know, little by little.
That's why now I go with the mentality of, well, I've always had this mentality too, but I always go as I make music because I love to make music.
Music, yeah.
I can grab a 12-pack and a bottle of Henny and go with him and make music because I enjoy doing
not
that.
It not felt
because
like a
I'm trying
job
to, I'm trying
try
to throw to it out it. Tomorrow because I'm going to be Daddy Yankee next week. Nah,
yeah,
it's not.
Yeah. No, and if, I feel
I'm
like if it happens, it,
because,
it happens.
Exactly,
but if it
exactly.
doesn't, at the end of the day, you're
that's
doing
like,
what you love to do.
Yeah, exactly. That's like even, you know, those kids, Meek Mill and all them kids, they wheelie a bike every day, not because they're going to get signed by fucking Red Bull tomorrow, but because they love wheelie that bike. They ride that bike every day. I like making music, you know what I mean? So
look at this, look at this. This is just an example. You know, I'm 33 right now, and we are not where we want to be. Even myself.
Where you're supposed to be. I think y'all supposed to be in a higher level.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But if you really look back at artists, my bad to cut you off.
No,
but if you really look back at artists, my favorite artist that came out as a white boy was Eminem. And when he actually came out, literally, he didn't blow up to like, damn near 40, we're like 37, 38 when he blew up. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
There's young artists.
But that's why you have to do it because you love it. You know
there's,
what I mean?
There's artists that now.
You can't
now,
put a cap on what year you're going
to. Shit, look at me. I'm 35 and this is when I'm starting to do this.
Yeah.
Hello,
but,
you know what I mean?
But you see that you genuinely love it too.
Oh, yeah,
like,
that's this
you
is
enjoy
my thing.
Doing it.
Yeah.
If you didn't, you wouldn't do it.
I don't see this as a job, even though people are like, how many jobs do you have? I have 3 jobs. But it's because I do my regular job, the bar, and Maze Radio. But Maze Radio, it's a networking thing. Bebba's Bar Talk is what I love to do.
Yeah.
You know
but
what I mean?
Something
I've always liked talking shit anyway.
Something inside you tells you you're going to take time off your kids, your whatever, your family to come do what you love. So something inside
to do
you.
Do your hobby.
Yeah.
That, you
uh-huh.
yeah.
No,
but,
and then the thing
is,
is my kids, I keep it a buck with my kids. I have a 16 and 12 year old. And even my little one, Nani, everybody knows Nani. You know Nani. She's like, tells me, she goes, are you doing, she reminds me, are you doing your show today?
Yeah,
or what?
Yeah,
or
yeah.
Don't you have an event? Like, they're on top
so
of
she's
it.
She's supporting you.
Yeah, oh no, they support me, even though my oldest says I'll never go viral, but I'm going to show her I'm going to go viral one day.
Yeah.
Okay, if it's beating her ass, going viral. I'm going viral, I don't give a fuck.
It's tight.
But it's like.
You get viral, that's it, you go.
But I feel like, do you guys have the support enough? Because at the end of the day, like, you guys have been doing this, is what, 2003?
Yeah.
2003,
in the early 2000s? 2004, early 2000s,
yeah. Do you guys, and I ask this question all the time, do you guys get this, were supported at that time back then, or are you guys getting more support now that you guys are back together?
When we first started around that time, we got a lot of support because of the simple fact that we come from a small city, Chelsea.
Yeah.
And there's not a lot of people that really came out of Chelsea like that. The only ones that I know that probably made a buzz, you know what I'm saying, was Gami.
Yeah.
Gami, Roca y Gami, ¿me entiendes? So, mm-hmm. so that for us was like, yo, you know, these... We were excited when they came out. Like, yo, these dudes came out of our hood.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
I know, it's a...
Malas mañas. Malas mañas.
It's a proud thing. Yeah. I get proud. That's what I'm saying. Like,
but no, people can support more.
Yeah, they can support more, especially knowing yeah. the background, especially knowing where you guys come from.
Online, we get, to be honest, zero on the pennies to the dollar when it comes to, you know, showing love mm-hmm. to us.
Yeah.
But when we go out, it's like everybody's like, yo, yeah. oh, your music, yo, my nigga, you need to go out, yo, you need to do this, you need to damn.
But, where, but did you but share it?
Love in
but
front
did you
of
like
everybody?
It? Exactly, yeah. because
that
exactly.
You know, you gotta show that same love in front of everybody.
So
you know
that's
mean?
How like, we see, that's how damn, we see like the haters from the actual support.
If you can get one, you know, 5-10 people to be like, yo, your music, I'm telling you can blow, that means we can get a million people.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
I feel like it's like como tú dices, like if you guys put out a song and like you Joshua is more into the social media, you Rafito, you're not into it.
He likes to like leave chunks.
But I see, but it's like, and we do, once we
I'm
started, ya tú sabes, you guys
now.
Started sending us music.
Yeah,
we
be,
you know what I mean? We support you guys, always support it.
Yeah,
you know what
yeah.
I mean? Hit you up, send it as soon as you guys are ready for interview.
Yeah, yeah.
Because that's what you're supposed to do, especially yeah. when we come from the same
yeah,
town.
Yeah.
That's
why I show y'all mad love too.
Yeah.
That's why I tell you guys and you.
Mm-hmm.
I say, yo, y'all got a great thing coming because y'all can take, you know, if y'all can gather everybody, artists from, you know, around this New England area, Connecticut, Boston, wherever, around our area, if you can get artists after artists after artists to be reality, y'all like almost the key to grabbing everybody and putting them together.
Can you say that louder for the people in the back?
No. That's what y'all already doing. Y'all getting every artist from around the way, New England area, where it's connected.
And not even New England. We have people in Cali. We have people in, yeah, we have people in Atlanta, New York, Cali, Mississippi, Louisiana.
So now y'all gotta figure out how to put all the pieces together to make all of them
mm-hmm.
click somehow.
That's one
or
thing that
like this one
we admire.
One,
yeah.
You know what I
that's
mean?
That's one thing that we admire, that not a lot of people in mass are supporting mass artists.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
you
yeah,
know
yeah,
what I'm
yeah,
saying?
Yeah,
and then especially I feel like everybody want to make it. Everybody, oh no, we got competition.
But nobody
want to. Instead of coming together and work, everybody want to be in competition.
Like
competition.
Yeah, it's
so
always
been.
I feel like now little
like
people are
years.
Getting a little bit more, not as much as we should
yeah.
be able to, but it's like a post, a share, takes 2.5 seconds.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm
yeah.
saying?
But the haters won't share that.
Oh no, they but you'll see more views than you see
yeah.
likes. It's like, I don't, like, to be honest, the other day I was like, I don't give a fuck about a like.
Yeah,
I know you
yeah.
see it though.
But that's
how I see
that's
it.
That's even the same yeah, thing with sorry to say.
I know you're watching though.
Yeah.
You're watching.
I know you're watching.
Sorry
you're
to
present
say,
out.
But I've heard a lot of people say this too, and it's the truth with DJs too in the city. You know
mm-hmm.
what I mean? What's it take a good a minute and a half to spin a record, a coro, and a
yeah.
first verse?
Yeah.
At least a verse,
take?
So people be like, oh shit.
But they have that mentality, like, all right, local rap, they're never gonna make it nowhere, or they're never gonna be nothing. They're
yeah.
stuck on that shit, and it, to be, you know, real, it is gonna be stuck on that if nobody actually.
Hopefully,
takes action
we gotta.
Like, yo, I'm gonna throw my city out. Because if one or two make it out the hood for real, like to that type of deal or that type of level, yo, who knows who
they'll
else
that
can bring
that DJ
back
with them.
Now,
or
this is the reason.
Boston in general, like to.
And
like,
now this is the reason why artists leave their city. This is why artists leave their city to go to another city, another state, to get that support, to get that love, because you're in your own city, and they're not even supporting you in your own city, in your own state. So guess what? We're gonna be like, fuck that.
Yeah,
we
yeah,
came
yeah,
from
yeah,
here,
yeah.
but we're about to go to New York, or DR, or PR,
yeah,
or Cali,
yeah, yeah.
Or Panama,
I ain't gonna love,
or
Colombia,
¿me entiendes?
I ain't gonna lie, it feels good getting love from your
from
city.
Other, but
yeah,
it does feel good.
It feels much more better
yeah,
than getting
amazing.
Love from
yeah.
somewhere else.
So
at the end of the day,
breaking out from here, you know what I mean? To be able to show love to more Boston people, and build that whole, the way Atlanta, Miami, New York
mm-hmm.
has all these, like, you know, groups that are doing it, we can be one too.
It does,
yo,
it does
Mass
feel
has
good.
A lot of talent.
It,
hell,
it does
yeah.
have a lot
Mass
of talent.
Mass has too much talent.
And it does feel good. One day, Figs hit us up like, yo, somebody at Walgreens just said you're the girl from the radio.
Yeah.
And then, like, I was in the mall the other day, somebody said Bella, and I'm like,
yeah,
and I be forgetting what the
yeah,
fuck
yeah,
I be doing
happens,
sometimes.
Exactly.
You know,
and
I
because now you're on your personal. Yeah. You're doing you. You're
that's
yeah.
how you. That's how you know it's
yeah.
real
yeah.
too.
That's
how you
dope.
Know the dream is real.
Mm-hmm.
It's unfolding. Everything that you're envisioning, it can unfold.
It's like
that
speaking
face.
Into existence.
Yeah,
oh,
who would have thought? 2 years ago.
This man right here was at a Walgreens one day. I forgot what he was grabbing. I remember I was in my car. He went into the Walgreens. And he goes, yo, Rafito. Some chick just came up to me and said, are you Yashua? And took a picture with me.
Yeah, I'm like, yo, that's dope.
You know how excited he was? Happened. Because it doesn't happen. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So for him, for that to happen to him for the first time, he was like, yo, that's dope. I'm like, they're supportive.
But that, yeah, and it also so
it feels good. It feels like you're being heard, you're being seen. Yes. Like, I don't give myself
a lot of work.
I don't give myself a lot of credit. And the other day, somebody hit me and I was like, yo, by the way, I forgot to tell you that I heard somebody was talking about them. What the fuck were they talking about? But it was good. It was good. Not because, honestly, even your own family are your haters.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Sometimes, yeah, like,
it's like that new song. You see a dream and nobody else sees. You know? But you're trying to get it no matter what they're talking about. No matter what they got to say about you, you're still trying to chase that dream.
It takes time. You're the only one who
sees
it.
Nobody else really sees it.
And it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, I feel like for me, I couldn't give two shits as long as I got that tunnel vision at the end of the day, you don't have to follow me, you don't have to like me, but at the end of the day, other people are liking and seeing what I'm doing.
You do for you. You know what I mean? Your family.
Yeah, because at the end of the day,
people. That's exactly. It. That's the only people you got to take. Everybody else, they're gonna. Absolutely. You can be a millionaire, billionaire, they're gonna talk. They're gonna
it's like me.
Down below, they're gonna talk.
My own family don't fuck with me. Do you think I give a fuck who fucks with me? That's how I see it. I had to. No, but it's true. I had to move away.
What is this called?
The Beba Bitch.
I need another one.
Of course you do, sweetheart. It's the Beba Bitch.
Yo, promocionando el traguito de Beba Bitch.
Mira.
The Beba Bitch is the shit. I'm just saying. Don't sleep on it.
Yeah. That was the little.
You had it too? You know? That's the Beba Bitch. You get promo, Henny. You already know the vibes, you know.
Drink. That's what? Hennessy and what?
Henny Prib.
Henny Prib.
It can't be regular Henny.
Henny Privilege.
Yeah, they taste
it. I remember. I got fruit. Yeah. It's so funny because at one point I didn't know my liquors. It's so funny. And I had given somebody $20 one time to get me Henny. They're like, yo. Let's get E and J. And I'm like, oh, okay, I don't give a fuck with E and J.
Even
I'm like,
I drank that not so long.
Yo.
I drank that like two. Like
that shit is done. The funny thing is, I had a bottle of Douce and they poured it in the bottle of Douce. That shit went because they thought it was Douce.
Yeah.
I should have charged $5 a fucking shot.
I was at the airport leaving Minnesota and I'm like, you got Hennessy? And they, no Hennessy. I'm looking, E and J.
Anything that's close to it.
I'm like, E and J.
They didn't have Remy?
Yeah.
Nah.
I like Remy.
Like
all
Remy's
white
soul,
nigga, pretty
yeah,
much.
Yeah, I could fuck with Remy. I'm like, 1738. I'm bougie. I've been bougie. If it's not 1738 or Priv, maybe Deuce. I can fuck with Deuce.
I like 17. I was on that way for a while.
But I'm glad you guys are back. I'm glad you guys are doing your thing.
We're working hard. We're working hard.
What is? I know you guys have put out a few singles already. Yeah. What is the next project you guys are working on?
Right now, like you said, we dropped a few singles. What we're trying to do is see, Sin La Llave has been in the chamber for too long. So what we plan on doing is just drop it on YouTube. Here you go, listen to that. You know what I'm saying?
New platforms.
Yeah, platforms too. But just like here you go. And what we want to focus now is on Lo Freaky because the style that we had back in the day.
It's coming
it's
back.
Still, it's still good. It's still good. But our swag
weird.
Now switched
nah,
up a little bit.
We just want to put, you know, the new
put out fresh. Yeah, something fresh because now I don't want to put it on. But yo, that sounds too old school.
We don't want the old project to go in vain. So we're still going to toss it out.
Yeah,
even
toss
though
it, out.
It sounds good still, you know what I mean? But so other people that heard it, they know that it's old songs, but it still sounds up to date.
Yeah,
so we're going to put that out so it's not, you know, doesn't waste. And then we're gonna work on
we work hard. Those are the times that we work hard.
By like
remember
and summer
at DJ Juni's crib.
It's hot.
At DJ Juni's house.
Shout out to DJ Juni.
DJ Juni. That's when it started. And like I said, DJ Juni.
They always had all the parties and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Who's calling me?
So we had the studio there 24/7. Wake up, speed, eat everything. Studio. Like go to McDonald's, grab. Five fucking dollar burgers and two fries just to get through the day and
yo,
studio.
I think that's how you're supposed to do. Like
we were really dedicated.
That was prior to the family.
Time, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, of course.
At the time,
you know,
it's when we were doing shows, you know, for this price here and this price here. That's when it started. Everything the train moving. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's how when we had to keep just the gas on the floor. And keep
so you, are you guys gonna start doing shows? Or are you guys gonna just start releasing and then see what?
Well, the promoters was popping.
We're trying to,
you know what I'm saying? It's all about
too,
the promoters.
We're trying to catch, we're trying to catch a
record. We're not just gonna run up in the club and grab the mic.
No, of course, because that's what I'm saying. I would think that now that you guys are back, you would get, I was thinking you guys would be getting people, yo, what's up?
Yeah, no, definitely.
You know what I mean?
To me, in my eyes, I want to catch a record right now that has enough traction around the city that we can do a show and have actual people support, you know what I mean? Have people into it because it's t- tough to do a show, yeah, you know, like 30 of our people come and then it's like a 200 people event. It's just not, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. I want to be able
yeah. to bring 100, 150 people that's our people there. Boom. All right.
And then whatever else other followers, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, mm-hmm.
So we can.
No, like fans, you know what I mean?
Yeah, because at the end of the day, you have your peoples, I have my peoples, Maze Radios has, you know what I mean? So it's like a domino effect. You know what I mean? Shoot. You guys can be part of the Vibes Not Violence event. You guys already, you guys are already automatically invited to be part of our events that we do. We're working on a lot of things, you know what I mean?
If it's good, then yeah, of course.
You know, Maze Radio, once you guys are Baba Bartok, you guys are inside the Maze. Mira, you have to order it with the server, sweetheart, before you. You can't just say, I want a Baba bitch.
You want a Baba bitch? I'll get you a Baba bitch.
Oh, viste.
Había mucha gente por allá como mi hermana.
Beba bitch and the virgin Beba bitch. How about that?
Who's gonna be better? I gotta be nice tonight.
Cheers, man.
Cheers.
For the whole new year and
you know, even though 2020 is a little fucked up, twisted and confusing, it's been good to us.
It started off a little fucked up with, you know, the government and the coronavirus and all that extra shit. Kobe dying, God bless
you.
Yo,
I know. R.I.P.
You know, it's just
fuck you, Corona, you fucking douchebag. Canceled everything. Tú sabes lo que? My first show, but you know what? It's coming because it's still gonna happen. Y'all better come.
Yeah,
my first comedy show.
Yeah.
Just
I
saying.
See that, I see that.
You know, I'm not just a pretty face. I'm also funny.
You gotta show some support, man. You know, show some support.
No, it's true. Like support, it doesn't come a long way. Javito.
Yo.
So I know, and I go to you guys. You guys have also worked with pretty dope artists. Yeah.
Thank God, man. We got blessed with that. You know, and shout out to my man Landizi because you know he was. Was basically the plow truck behind that, pushing us and helping us out with that. We went to Puerto Rico. We worked with Yampi, AG Lavo, Que Paz Descanse. You know, I was out there with my man, Mr. P. I don't wanna, you know what I'm saying, say too much about that, but you know, they showed us, you know, a lot of love when we went out there. And Anto Pauta actually reached out to DJ Luyan, and through DJ Luyan, he said, would you like a record with Farruko, Arcangelo, or with Jody? And I was like, you know what? At that moment, Farruko estaba haciendo cosas, te digo, muy comercial and everything, you know what I'm saying? Arcángel le mete cabrón, but he was more like on that underground shit. And I really wanted to, and if I wanted to get Jody, I'd just, you know, be like, yo, Josh, doesn't matter. Because he's being a my nigga. Jody's nasty, but my nigga Josh también, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
It's like a similar.
Yeah, similar, yeah. Yeah. So I was like, fuck it. So whatever, I picked Farruko. We did, you know what we did? We did the record, we went to PR. We did the video, and in transition, we ended up hooking up with Luyan, and we did the video with Farruko, and then we actually did a record with Ñengo Flow, which was pretty dope because we were at Home Studios, and the dude from Home Studio heard the whole record on the phone. He goes, yo, this shit sounds dope. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? ¿Dónde tú grabaste esto? And my manager, Vito, was like, yo, listen, our manager, Vito, you know what I'm saying? Vito Shop in La Casa.
Is it Liricotas Records still, right?
Liricotas Records, Matándolo Music.
Okay.
So, basically, we showed him Vito. Yo, se fue en un estudio casero allá. Rafito hizo los ritmos, you know, él mezcló todo and everything. He goes, diablo, ustedes le meten and everything. Yo, le tengo una sorpresa a ustedes. And it was funny because prior to that, he ended up getting a phone call. Mm. So he goes, dame un break que les tengo una sorpresa a ustedes. Ñengo Flow estaba llegando de Colombia a Puerto Rico. Dímelo, baby. Aterricé. Mira, llégate al estudio que te tengo una sorpresa. So seguimos ahí mezclando los temas como tal. I was getting my hair cut out back. And Ñengo Flow pulls up to the studio. And we were like, oh shit, estaba con Sinfónico, Onyx, Edward Fendel. You know, it was dope. It was dope. Mm-hmm. You know, we got to meet these producers and shit. And then Ñengo. Y nosotros terminamos haciendo negocio. Grabamos con Ñengo, que es el tema Perrea Mi Mami. Yo.
Everything was like meant to be.
It was like meant to be.
Yeah,
everything
we went
was
out
like,
there with Oney. You know, he was supposed to finish off his business with Farruko, shoot the video.
It was, you had different plans, but then obviously
we
got.
Can do, it was that, and whatever we can do, you know.
We did the video.
When we got there, it was like, God was blessing us after blessing, after blessing, after blessing. Recording over here. Let's go over here.
It was
all being the pieces of the puzzle being put together.
Hopefully that comes again. You know what I mean? Because I feel like, you know what I mean? Yeah, I got to go to Puerto Rico again. Flights are real cheap. And aprovechen ahora. The flights are real cheap. Tienes en pa allá. You never know. You know what I mean? That whole perreo vibe is coming back.
En realidad, hay que salir.
Yeah, you have to.
¿Me entiendes? Si nosotros hubiéramos estado en Puerto Rico,
o viviendo allá por lo menos dos o tres meses con las conexiones, hubiéramos hecho una estampa bien cabrona.
Yeah.
We would have definitely made a motherfucking hit. Oh, you know what I'm saying? And made something of ourselves.
I think
it's not easy because we're out here and the connections ain't out here. The connections are in PR, Florida, New York. So
Atlanta,
you have to leave
yeah.
your own state to make things happen.
And do you guys think you guys will be leaving? Or you guys are going to try to see if you guys could
Well, for me, what I have envisioned for us is whatever we get blessed with along the time. Right
yeah.
now, I'm just focusing on making really good music and really good visuals when we can. When we're ready to,
yeah.
we're going to shoot this video and make it amazing, we're going to do that. But as of right now, I'm just taking blessed.
It's like we'll catch that bridge when we get
yeah,
there.
I'm not going to go, oh, I got to go run and do this.
Yeah,
no, I'm not putting
because
myself
like I said,
that no more.
We got family now.
Yeah.
That's exactly
yeah,
so
también you got to think about, it's like me with the girls and it's like, okay, what if Florida is the state? Or what if, but I got
exactly.
two girls that I got
to
make sure that they're going
to... have to go to PR and do this?
Yeah.
Like that, then, yeah
it all really depends.
Step,
si ahora mismito, okay, suponiendo,
yeah,
tirar un lado, voy a tirar un lado, voy a tirar un lado. Okay, que se decida Darian, que Wisin y Yandel, que ya tienen chavo con cojones, ya se quieren retirar y abrir su compañía, ya tienen su compañía,
yeah,
pero
yeah,
tienen
yeah,
al artista.
Like
y venga,
like that, yeah,
y venga Wisin y Yandel, yo los queremos firmar a ustedes.
Business,
ok, Tato,
business.
Vamos para allá, vamos a
yeah,
hablar.
Of course,
y
because
nos
you
firman.
Gotta be which one yeah.
Ahora,
the best
you know,
for you guys.
If there's somebody
yeah.
that yo, my nigga, I want to invest this, and he's really about it, wants to get it, then
we'll
that's another blessing.
But we're not going to leave. We're not going to stop doing
about,
what we're doing
yeah,
for our family. And
se van a seguir de Guatemala para meterse a Guatapeor.
It has to be good business. You
know?
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like that's how it should be nowadays. You gotta, like, it's like, look at Megan Thee Stallion.
Yeah,
ella
yeah,
hizo
yeah,
business
yeah.
esto y no quisieron que ella sacara música.
Yeah, yeah,
she had
yeah,
to sue him.
Had
and, you know what I mean?
Esa es la madre también. Que nosotros no queremos que alguien no venga a firmar. Okay, siéntate ahí en el bench.
No, that's not.
Wow, we got all these niggas playing. No. Oh, mira, me gusta ese tema que ustedes hicieron.
Dámelo para dárselo a esa persona.
No, sino firmarte como artista, vamos a trabajar como artista, no te dejes sentado allí.
If we're gonna sign on a label like that, it has to be a deal that we can't undeny.
Yeah.
But mainly what I'm looking for us is basically a publishing deal that's gonna sign us as a label, so we can push ourselves.
Yeah, because you guys have
control over our music, our videos,
and we can do it.
And do you see yourself, if you don't do music, you also see yourself as a producer?
As
engineer,
a if it's like that, too. I don't care for being an artist. You know, I got to the point that I was like, you know what, I don't
no,
even care.
He's an artist producer.
You know?
Yeah.
But he'll make a fucking hit.
That's
somebody.
What I'm saying.
Yeah.
That
yeah.
I'm th- that
if
see
they
obviously
hit from beat and lyrics.
Exactly. That's
yeah.
what I'm saying. That you're not just an artist.
No.
You are a jack of all trades in
I'm
the music.
I'm a composer. I can write
yeah.
dope music.
Yeah.
I can make you a beat. You know what I'm saying? I do a little bit of everything.
Mm-hmm.
Shit, yo, you let me know, you come holler at me, I'll give you a haircut, my nigga. I just come
and from
PR.
A haircut too, yeah. You want to make a banger and leave there with a fresh haircut?
I know, get it for the video.
For the video.
Pero nada, you know, y gracias a este caballero también que cuando estábamos en Puerto Rico nos apoyó a full, ¿me entiendes?
Caballero,
ven para acá, ustedes conocen al pana mío, ven para acá, para acá.
Mira, dime, lo estamos aquí, ya tú sabes, aquí un saludo aquí a la gente, a Beba, y a los brothers.
Mr. Better, you know,
Rafito,
activo, gracias,
aquí,
de verdad.
Sabes, coño.
Él acaba de salir del avión, ¿verdad? Did he just do it today? Did you guys come in?
Llegué ayer.
Oh, llegaron ayer. ¿Te chequearon para el corona?
Por favor de Dios, estamos ready.
Ya, dame el sanitizer.
Ay, no, toma, guau, porque tú sabes este avión, yo no sé, papi, yo no sé, uno nunca sabe, pero ni que era mental.
Pero como dice, ya tú sabes, nosotros no nos caemos y con el coronavirus no nos vamos a caer. Ese es el lema de nosotros, el que me conoce lo sabe, Mr. Pérez, no nos caemos.
Pero de verdad, gracias a este personaje aquí, de verdad, que él apoyó mucho a Rafito y a Shuber. Cuando nosotros llegamos allá a la mansión, estaba Juni, estaba todo el combo, there was like 21 of us over there, ¿entiendes? Y estaba él, estaba el panita mía Mushroom, de verdad, un shout out to Mushroom, estaba ahí
Mata,
la voz, Mata, estaba Jumpy, ¿me entiendes?
Todos
estábamos ahí trabajando súper a fuego, ¿me entiendes? Yo, he showed us the ropes out there. He was like, yo, listen, you know, I got these people. So he rode with us over there.
Por la energía, nos dejamos ir por la energía.
Sí, porque algunas veces la vibra y las energías, porque...
Los reales se reconocen entre ellos.
Real recognizes real.
A veces uno aprende las cosas a la fuerza, pero... con esta gente no me equivoqué.
No, yeah.
¿Se puede hablar malo?
No se puede hablar malo. Pues
no me equivoqué un carajo.
Even when you say, oh, what's up, man? Somebody from that handshake, he's official.
And he stayed with us in the mansion.
Ajá,
the whole time.
Sí, que si fuera otro, se hubiese ido, lo hubiese dejado.
Nosotros nos conocimos en un estudio de un, para mí, el mejor productor que hay en el género, que se llama Yampi, que empezó con Ñengo.
Yampi, ¿verdad? Yampi, no cambia el beat.
Si no llega a ser por ese ministro, no hubiéramos conocido. Nos conocimos en un estudio donde él empezó, y ese ministro ahora está trabajando en los mejores estudios con Scott Storch y la gente más poderosa de la música. Nosotros nos conocimos en el estudio del ministro. Y hicimos la conexión, y cuando yo, esta gente había alquilado una mansión.
No te tumbando cosas acá.
Esta gente tenía una mansión alquilada, y yo decía, cabrón, ustedes tienen
Airbnb.
No,
y se conocieron a él, you know what I mean? So it's just still, like the connections,
looking,
networking.
Out of nowhere, look at how crazy.
Out of all of them, on
today, out of all of them, we had a record.
So it's dope because it's like how you, la gente, los strangers become family in a way.
You know, Dios los cría.
Yeah, and it's
there's
like
there's some strangers that are more family than friends.
Can you say that louder?
There's
because
some strangers and friends that are more family.
And I could be attest to that.
La sangre te hace pariente, pero la lealtad te hace familia.
Say it louder for the people in the back.
Lírico de Record, Matándolo Music, Nos Caemos In, Grandisi, tú sabes, la familia.
You already know the vibe, so ya tú sabes.
Yo, mira, y un saludito al Código que está por allá atrás, Big Lucky, que está junta, fuerte y poderosa.
Big Lucky está behind the scenes siempre.
Gracias a Farruko, gracias a Carbon Fire Music, a Fran Miami, que me dieron la mano y me pusieron donde yo estoy hoy en día, ¿entiendes? Y ya tú sabes, vamos a seguir para adelante siempre, agradecido y...
Matando la liga, nos fuimos. So ya tú sabes, don't forget, every Thursday, 88.5. So ya tú sabes, Bebas Bar Talk, Joshua, Rafito, you already know. Matando la liga, tú cuando vayas a Puerto Rico, tú le dices que tú fuiste para Bebas Bar Talk. I'm kind of sort of a big deal.
Seguro que sí.
Mira, espérate, que viste cómo estamos nosotros, cómo estamos ahora. So you already know. Thank you for coming to Beba's Bar Talk, guys. You already know your family with us. Whatever we are in, we will be letting you guys know, because at the end of the day, you guys need to be heard, not just here but worldwide. You know what I mean? You guys are part of the Back to the Lab not so long ago. The first week when we started Back to the Lab.
Yeah,
you was in it. So you already know they're part of it.
We're not gonna talk about that.
No, we're not gonna talk about that second time. Back to the Lab. We're not gonna talk about that one. We'll talk about that in another show. But
I wanna be. I wanna say something real quick. I wanna shout out everybody, every artist, whether they do reggaeton, hip hop, whatever, rap.
Nesto, Loki,
everybody. Cam, my nigga, the dudes from Worcester, my nigga, Gino, everybody. I wanna shout out everybody that's doing music on Dogs, my nigga.
We all gotta do it like this.
En la unión está la fuerza, así hay que trabajar.
Do it from the heart.
Aquí lo hacemos real.
Ya tú sabes.
You know?
No nos vamos a dejar.
Oh, se va a meter la japiar.
No me pongas a empezar. Porque después no voy a terminar.
A ver. ¿Qué pensaste? Let's go. Vamos.
Dice, títere. Me fumo mi blon a los títeres. ¿Estás seguro? Tomo la pepa de pura cepa, salí de la prisión con el grillete.
Dale.
Me vengo con Beba, al Beba Blue Talk.
No, tranquilo, que yo vine aquí a hacer el intervino, vine a rapear.
So you already know, ¿dónde pueden conseguirlos ustedes? Instagram
at Rafi Motif, at Rafi underscore Motif, at JFU and YouTube. That's Joshua.
De furu.
Yo tengo Mr. Pérez oficial, Mr. Pérez oficial, que a mí ya me han hackeado como dos cuentas, hay un envidioso por ahí en mi bien, pero si me estás viendo, te voy a picar los dedos y sé quién tú.
Yo, but if you type me,
y Mr. Pérez oficial, que tú sabes.
Yachua matándolo.
Yachua matándolo.
En YouTube, you guys are on all platforms.
Graffiti Yachua.
Graffiti Yachua.
Gracias, Beba, gracias.
You know the vibe,
quiere salir pa' donde no sé. Conmigo ella quiere amanecer. Ella quiere salir pa' donde no sé. No le importa, solo quiere amanecer. Mamá, en la cama. Empújame pa' atrás, que te voy a dar. Hacerte gozar como